Hi there, Su-Lynn. So following on from the introduction, we're going to look at how we can separate out our layers. So just as a reminder, we're just going to go to perspective view so we can just have a look at how those layers look when they are separated out. The perspective view is a really great one to be able to observe where your layers are in Z space. It gives us this 2.5D effect. To activate this, you're using your keys, which is Command and Option key on the Mac, holding them down, and then just with your pen or your mouse, you're just rotating it around so you can see the view from any angle. It's pretty neat. So here we have the multiplane design. Just as a reminder for this exercise, what you need to do is to create a scene which has a foreground, a midground, and a background. For the foreground, I have a selection of trees just for speed and for simplicity. I've duplicated a few of those. One thing I should probably show you and may not have shown you before is just how to create this backdrop, which is a really great way to organize your drawings. Here, we haven't got anything in terms of a backdrop. So I'm going to show this as an example. So we're just going to click and drag across, and then we can just insert and then just go to backdrop. And if you want to adjust it to just a corner, just to pull that out, adjust it to usually central and then click off it. When we move it, it moves as one unit. So let's start with the foreground, and I'm just going to show you how we set this up in terms of moving the layers in Z space. Command P to add a peg, put multiple pegs on. Well, we do that by just again selecting, click and drag, and then go to Shift Command P. Let's go ahead and start with this foreground layer, which is this item here. It's highlighted because I've selected on its peg. Just check with tool properties you've got peg selection on. Let's go ahead and make sure we've got the rotation point in. So with the rotation point, so I'm actually going to deselect something that I've already set up, which is the floor. And as you can see, it cuts off some of my drawing because I've already positioned this drawing in the X plane. I'm going to disable it, selecting it and hitting D to deselect. To enable it, it is A. With that deselected, that allows me to see where I need to put my rotation point. So it's at the bottom of its little trunk. Let's open up the property, enable 3D, go to the top view and see where it lies. Now with the top view, it gives us this cone and the camera is placed at the clipping pane closest to us, which is set at 1, and the far clipping pane is by default set at 1000. So the camera is set at 1. The item that we're looking for is the foreground. Go to our Translate tool, and this is in the Advanced Animation Tools. The Translate tool allows us to move any of our pieces in Z space. We see the arrows, which allow us to make sure it's locked off, and I would always advise you move it on the arrow rather than the actual point where it looks like a rotation, because then that moves it freely. So let's go ahead and do that. And immediately we start to push it back. We can see it pops behind the other layers because by default, all the layers are put in the same position. You can see it scaling, and that is not what we want. We want scale to be seen in a more naturalistic way with a camera added. Select the peg. Then we need to go up to our advanced animation tools. This tool here, maintain size, and select that. We can now go to back to our top view. When we move this piece behind the other layers, it still pops, but it's not scaling. For this piece, it's the foreground for me, so I want it in front of everything else. Okay, so let's go to the next piece. For me, it's the next tree. I'm going to select its peg. It's better to have animate off. Just make sure you set that so that you're not keyframing already. So we're just positioning right now. With the peg selected, we're going to first of all go with the rotation point placed at the bottom. We can go to the top view. Make sure maintain layers is selected, move the piece in Z space. We can actually go ahead and actually see where that is by going to the perspective view. Shortcuts are Option Command and then rotate. The tree we've moved is in front of all the other layers. I can see that my tree is slightly above the ground. Look at adjusting that. Translate tool on. I can move it down. Back to the camera view and then repeat it for all the other pieces. Following on, I've got one that I made earlier. We can see that we've got pegs on all of the drawings. Also, we've separated out everything in Z space. So this is kind of what mine looks like right now. So I have everything in the different foreground, midground, and background layers. We can then look at putting a camera in. If we go back to our camera view, I have my example here where I've already put a camera in, so we can see the movement of the camera as it weaves through some of the layers. We start to see that separation in Z space that we have set up. To get the camera up, go to the same place that we would find putting in a new drawing. So it's the plus sign just above the layers. So we're going to select the camera. When the camera appears, it should not be connected to the main composite. The camera can only be animated if it has a peg on it. Select it and then Command P, open up the property. Enable 3D path. That's something that I'll show you how that looks next. Also enable 3D so we can make a 3D camera. Let's go ahead and do that. Go over to our timeline, just select that, go to O to take me straight there. We can see here that the camera selected on the peg, so that's really important. Again, go to your tools and make sure peg selection is on. Put in our first keyframe. This could be our first position for the camera. You can move the camera in the camera view using those locked off arrows. You can move it in the top view, so it's just really preference on how best you want to manipulate everything. What you're seeing as well is the limitations of your layout design. I'm starting to see the edges. So you need to sort of plan. Let's go ahead and position the first camera position. Maybe that you want to zoom in a little bit first, something like this. What we'll do is to move it in time. Let's go to frame 60, move the camera again. It creates a keyframe for you automatically. And then I might have more of a slight move up, or let's just move it to an end position. My scene length set at 200. You've probably got a default to 60. To extend that, go to scene length. I'm on frame 200, so I'm finishing off my camera move. I'm going to move it across so it's like a pan. So I'm maybe doing a nice little pan up, finishing off my story here. So those are my keyframes, but what I need to do now is to add my in-betweens. So we're going to go with the set motion keyframes, select this, or we can go with the shortcut Command K. So let's take a look at how that is looking for us. So I've got my camera mask on just so that I can see how that looks. Let's play. How do we adjust with our camera peg selected? Have a look at our path of action. We can go over here. It looks like an orange train track, so it's to show control. And we can see here the path of action. Go to the perspective view just to get a better view of what that path of action is. So we can see that is kind of what's happening. And it's what I kind of said. I've got a establishing shot, which is pretty wide. And then it moves, it pans, but it moves upwards a little bit. And then it's an arc, it's moving in. And with most path of actions, we try and achieve an arc path of action. So this is very much sort of more animation skills. What we can also do, because we've enabled 3D path, is to add more points without adding more keyframes. And to do that, we just hover around the point where we may want to add something and we just hit P and it creates this little pink dot. When I hover over it, and I'm going to zoom in here, it gives me the movement tool. Can you see like the translate tool? And I can now shift that and create another path or a different sort of path of action. I can manipulate that without creating multiple keyframes. So that's, again, it's pretty nifty in terms of like creating a more interesting movement. So yeah, at any point. But I can also adjust my keyframe movement. So make sure that you're actually on the keyframe and I can move that. So I can push that back. So the camera not only pans across, but it curves inwards as well. And that will give me the illusion of, again, giving me the Z space perspective. So at any point, as I'll show you again, you just hover over the show controls, hit P, and then adjust it. You can just bend it back so it gives you this really nice curve. And again, make sure if you want to move the original keyframe, make sure you're on it to push it back just to smooth out that curve to give it a nice smooth path of action for the camera move. So there we go. That is adding a camera move, but also using a 3D path. So let's have a look at that in our camera view. Once you've finished adjusting the path of action, if it's distracting, hide the controls by going to the white train track over here. So let's just take a look. So it's a subtle change, but it's just slightly a little bit more complex in terms of the camera move. So there we go.